Hello friends, welcome to Srivalli's kitchen. Now I am going to show you how to prepare a chutney using this is called Dabbakaya in Telugu, or it is citron in English. These are those big huge lemons which we use pretty much frequently in South India. We make chutney out of it, or we make the yearly pickle, or we even make pulihora. Just like lemon rice, we have rice we make using this dabbakaya. Now I am going to show you how to make a chutney. For that we need dry red chilies, mustard seeds, methi seeds, fenugreek or fenugreek seeds, some jaggery, and some salt, which is not in the picture. It's very simple. We're just going to roast the mustard seeds, methi, and dry red chilies in oil. We're going to let it cool down, and we're going to powder it. Then we're going to chop this into tiny pieces along with the skin and all. Just remove the seeds if there are any, chop it into tiny pieces. Boil it, add some salt, jaggery, this powder, everything, and we're almost done. Right, first I'm going to add these into it. Since the oil is already hot, it will start to splatter soon, and then I'm going to add the red chilies. For those who do not know, okay, that's the chimney there. Dabbakaya or citron has a very sour, bittery, tangy taste. It has all elements of citrus along with some nice bitter flavor to it. So we just have to be careful while using it, because if the bittery flavor is in excess and we do not balance it, whatever we make is going to become a waste. So we just have to be more careful while preparing the rice with it. But for chutney, we can to an extent adjust the flavors. We're going to roast this a little till it turns crisp, let it cool down, and grind it into a powder. This powder is actually very useful because you add the same powder to gongura pickle, you add the same powder to a lot of other pickles. We add the same powder to the wood apple chutney also, or the Dabbakaya Pachadi. You can make this in advance and store the powder also if you want. But it doesn't taste really as good as a fresh one. But still, that's fine. You can store it for a week or 10 days in an airtight box. Turn off the heat. This is going to have nice strong hit to it, so just be careful. We're going to let this cool down and powder it. Meanwhile, we're going to chop the citron or the dabbakaya. Now I'm going to show you how to cut the citron. You can use a knife, no issues. Just remove the head part. The skin is very thick, so it's going to take some nice heavy work to get that done. Okay. See how thick it is. Okay, this is how it looks on the inside, just like your big Italian lemons. We are going to use only half today, so let's get started on it. Make sure you eat some pretty heavy breakfast before you start working on this. Right. De-seed it, or you can remove the seeds as you chop it. This has a very strong smell also. It's almost 10 times that of a lemon. And for someone like me who doesn't really like the citrus flavor, Remove the seeds as you go and cut it into pieces. If you are making the yearly pickle, you don't have to cut it into such small pieces. Keep cutting. Okay. It has a very, very strong citrus flavor, and I am not sure about it personally. But for all those who love oranges and lemons, you're going to absolutely go crazy about this pickle, I'm sure. There's a lot of liquid in it also. Very juicy. Yeah, but don't try to make a juice out of this and drink, because it is very bitter. The bitterness is the dominant flavor of the citron. You need a lot of sugar, and it's not worth the calories. But chutney, yes, of course. Okay. We're going to cut the other piece also the same way, and then we're going to go with the next step. Alright, now so we have the pieces ready. We have the chili and mustard seeds ground into a powder, so that's also ready. We're going to start with getting this cooked. And place this on a stove. Add some water to it. Right, now we're not going to add anything else, just put the heat on. Something between simmer and medium. Let it bubble up. Once it comes to a boil, we are going to add salt. Then a little while later, say about a minute or two later, we are going to add this powder. And we are also going to add jaggery. Just taste it before you add jaggery or the powder, or even after it, so that you'll know exactly how much more to add. All we have to do now is to wait for this to start bubbling up. Right, it's bubbled for around 5 to 7 minutes, and you can see you're getting a paste like thing here. To this, we are going to add salt around 1 heat spoon, because this is very, very bitter. And we are going to add the powder, chili powder we have grinded. Mix it up nicely. Keep mixing it up. Just reduce the heat when you're doing it. Put it on simmer and get going. Another tip, or a very important thing which I did not tell you before, is that you are not supposed to eat the skin, because it's very hard and no amount of cooking or boiling is going to soften it up soon. So you're only going to eat this pulp. Mix this with rice and then you're going to throw this skin away. We are using or cooking along with the skin because we want the flavors to come in, but we're not going to eat this part. You can see it is pretty hard even now while the seeds have softened up nicely. Not the seeds, but the, you know, the insides have softened up. Now it's time to add jaggery also. I cut the jaggery into pieces, so that it will be easier. I added only half the jaggery I've shown you. I'm gonna mix it up. Once this jaggery melts, we're just going to taste it just to know how much of which ingredient needs to go in. And we're going to add the remaining. This goes well with rice. You can have it with roti also, I guess. In the ending, we are going to give it a very simple tempering of mustard seeds and cumin seeds with a nice hit of asafoetida that is cane. Okay. I think the jaggery is already melted, so we're going to taste it. See if we need to add anything. It is still going to be a little bitter. We need to add some jaggery. Yep, mix it up. Some chili powder also, the one we've grinded, and some salt as well. Right. Let's just come together. The water has to kind of evaporate a little, not much, because it's going to be a little liquidy like this. It's going to be more like a paste kind of a thing. For another minute or two, we are going to let this sit, and then we're going to turn off the heat, temper it, and serve it. I've now turned off the heat and brought it down. You can see the consistency. It's going to be like this. One thing is that once you add the ground chili powder and jaggery, you have to keep stirring it continuously, or it's going to stick to the bottom of the dish. Just stir it, mix it up, make sure it is the consistency you get. Take it off the heat, and we're going to temper it. We don't have to wait for this to cool down to temper it. Here I have oil ready. I'm using groundnut oil. You can use normal sunflower or rice bran oil as well. Mustard seeds, cumin seeds, or jeera. Some nice set of cane. Yes, you can see this, since this is groundnut oil, it's going to froth. Once the mustard seeds splatter, we're going to turn off the heat, mix it into that chutney. The chutney is going to stay good for about 3 to 5 days. You can either leave it outside or you can put it into your refrigerator. Up to you. And you can also see that I've not really taken much of oil. You don't need too much oil as well. So this is fairly decent recipe. The mustard is starting to splatter. Yes. You can hear them crackling. This is when I turn off the heat. Here we go. Add it. Okay. I just love that sound. Mix it up nice and good. Let it sit for say half an hour, 1 hour, and then serve it. So that all the flavors are gonna get nice. Once the flavors get infused, you're gonna get a good taste. Still, the chutney is going to be a little bitter, a little sour, a little tangy. Maybe very mildly sweet and nice and hot. I'm going to take this into a serving bowl next. So here we have Dabbakaya Pachadi or citron chutney, ready to serve with rice or even roti. Yes, and do not forget that you are not supposed to eat that flesh or that skin. You are only supposed to eat the pulp. Thank you for watching, and if you like my videos, do subscribe to Srivali's Kitchen. Have a nice day.